The Colonial Dame's mission statement is historic preservation, honoring the ancestors who have gone before and made America great, and education.
The real foundation is the passion of the Dames to preserve our story, wherever that may be in the U.S., and especially in Missouri.
There is no better caretaker in the world.
Since 1949, the Colonial Dames, the Missouri Society of the National Society of Colonial Dames, have owned the Bull Duke House, which is a National Historic Landmark in its own right.
St. Genevieve is known for its French colonial history. That is our claim to fame. We have a significant amount of original architecture that stays in place, that is an example of that French colonial, and the Bull Duke House being one of the best preserved houses that we have that is available for tour.
Nobody is like the Danes. They really take care of them.
It's a fairly primitive looking building, the vertical log set on a sill and with the hipped roof and all the artifacts that are appropriate for the late 18th century and very early 19th century. We've been interpreting, if you will, the first community of St. Genevieve in its current location through the architecture for 60 years.
And in order to do it, we want people to come to St. Genevieve. We want them to see the house where Louis Bull Duke lived, see some of the other homes in the area, experience what it was like.
Well, we have some of the oldest houses in the country west of the Mississippi.
It's not just the buildings, it's the story of people who helped to create the foundation of this wonderful nation of ours. Because Louis Bull Duke was one of many. He was an ordinary person, but he did extraordinary things. And America's made up of ordinary people doing extraordinary things.
It's a multicultural story, and you miss that if you just come looking at a house.
It's impossible to remove French from North America because they were really the first to spread and colonize and explore with the help of the local Indians.
This was where you went if you wanted a new life, you know, new France. If you wanted an opportunity, you started up usually up in the Quebec, Canada area, came down the rivers, and this is what happened with St. Genevieve.
We have the French who are fleeing a little bit later, the Haitian slave revolt, like René Lemieux, who married Louis Bull Duke's granddaughter and built our Lemieux house next door. It tells a Native American story that particularly touches three tribes, the Shawnee tribe, the Delaware tribe, and the Osage tribe. It touches the Senegalese West African slave story, which is a narrative that is not been told at all well anywhere, I don't think. And it tells the early American story as it pushes in to these French right after the Louisiana Purchase.
After the French Revolution, a lot of French come over from France after that. They couldn't believe how laid back the people were here. That's one thing we try to teach the kids in school, you know. What you see on TV, the way the Americans did, that wasn't the way it was done here.
They got to know the people in the area. They became friends with them. They became partners.
The French were very egalitarian. They treated the Indians like brothers.
Well, I think the Indians may have been a little hesitant at first, but once they realized that the French were trying to come in and to mingle and to just live in the area, there was a great trust.
We cannot forget that we're a combination of numerous cultures. And it's not important who's first. The importance is we all became one.
What I want to have happen is that when somebody steps into New France at the Bull Duke House Museum, that they immerse themselves in a story that is being told nowhere else.
I think it's more possible to understand our blessings today if you understand what had to be overcome 200 years ago.
Now, they didn't walk in, just flip a switch on the thermostat, and all of a sudden it was 70 degrees inside when it was 100 degrees outside.
We are, of all of the places in town, uniquely qualified by our collection of houses and the background for them to tell that colonial story.
The importance of knowing where you've been and preserving that for future generations is something that should be first and foremost in any community.
And if you don't know who you were, sometimes you don't know who you are and you don't know where you're going.
It's a really quite unique story.
fourth graders in Missouri studied Missouri history, and our Bold Duke House is pictured in their history book. So when they come, they do know a little bit about what they're going to see. And they're just, I just enjoy talking with the children.
And anything we can do to help maybe spark an interest in history, then that's our goal. And that's my goal. And that's why I got into this.
It's like a time capsule.
We do not want to lose it.
If we've done our job at all as a museum, our visitors will leave asking different questions than they were asking when they came.
If you walked into our houses in the block, in the area where we are, if you went in and you saw these folks, you would see them dressed in the period of some 1792 to about 1820 is about the period of time, and you would listen to their stories about what was going on.
People of St. Genevieve like to get dressed in period clothing and to provide an additional level of interpretation of the history of the town.
Little kids, we teach them how to drill with wooden rifles like they used to drill.
It makes history fun for them.
I've even had kids like 2 years old that the rifle was about a foot and a half taller than they are. And when they come here and they know that the French militia is going to be here and they know that they're going to have the opportunity to do that, they just like doing it.
It's exciting to see as a parent.
It's hands-on is the best way you can teach them. And that's what we as a militia try to do. They love it.
One day I was baking egg custard pie in the Dutch oven, and one of the school teachers seen that and she couldn't believe it. And next day I was baking a rum cake in one, and this lady school teacher comes by and she said, "He's baking a cake in there. He's baking a cake in there." She said, "I can't even do that good at home."
You know, we need the participation of people in every level, from the person who wants to work in our textile garret above the LeMayer house and make woven things to put in our shop, to the person who wants to help in the garden, to the person who wants to buy a building.
There's lots of opportunity, but it all, of course, takes money. And we're looking to the communities, to people who care about historic preservation, to help us make the dream of New France, the other colonial America, come true.
Unless we had preserved the Louis Bold Duke House, we wouldn't have the bones of the story to tell going forward.
I just think it would be a shame if it was not continued.
I'm excited about it, personally, because there's so many people who do not even realize that St. Genevieve has places like the Bold Duke House. And if we can expand the property and make it more of a destination along with St. Genevieve and complement each other, I think it's probably going to be one of the greatest things that could happen to our French colonial history, to the Bold Duke House, and to our town.
So the houses that we're hoping to acquire would include the first commandant's house and the last commandant's house, so that we can wrap the whole colonial story on one campus.
This is the most important house in Missouri. It is vitally important that this house be preserved and the others like it around here.
We have shopping, we have dining, and we have wineries. But first and foremost, what is most important to us is our French colonial history, the preservation, the interpretation, and the sharing of that history.
We can bring tourism to St. Genevieve, to Missouri, to southern Missouri, and it's a good thing for everyone involved.
We hope that we are channels that will help educate other people, get other people interested in it, and that someday we'll be able to take 60 militiamen on a keelboat to St. Louis.
It's a unique little town that's sleepy and little changed for 200 years, and that's its beauty.
Very festive. The French had another way of just celebrating everything. And so they had great festivals and dances and just a lot of fun amongst all the hard work. And in the meantime, they created profits that in turn turned around and built the houses and built the town and in turn invested in something else. And what you had was America. This is a little capsule of what America is all about.